Alright, welcome to a Dark Souls 2 Scholar of the First Sin No Death, No Bonfire run, or at least an attempt. Starting out with Knight and Healing Wares, pretty standard fare. I've already got the Gold Pine Resin and Silky Stone, so I do that off screen because of the I like to spend some time with the character creator because then it feels a little bit more invested. I don't know, maybe this doesn't actually work or mean anything because I haven't succeeded in one of these runs yet. I think it's pretty worth getting the dagger here because it's really good for backstab damage, and I can pretty much do it without taking any hits, usually, and without wearing out any weapons, so it's kind of an easy choice. See, I just had to say no damage, right? I've died on that jump more than I care to admit. No big loss with the Silky Stone, it's just RNG. It's more money to sell to Gavilon. I have it on good authority that he wields and also deals. Not necessarily in that order. Do this out of order from how I normally do it, and it actually kind of confuses me later on. It just, you should have a fixed set of things to do. I'm just kind of experimenting with doing more things because I normally run straight for Dragon Rider because that's where the run passes or fails, but in this case I was trying to be more invested, be like, this is a real run, I'm gonna get all the things right now, because that makes a difference, right? That's not a rhetorical question. I do want to know if it makes a difference. Relevant to my interests. I always try to get the most cinematic display while talking to NPCs. Should I imagine I'm the cameraman?
And if the protection.
Please pardon the edit here. I'm not sure if it was the kids or dinner or something like that, but I wound up just running out the clock on the time recording, so I didn't do anything and I came right back. Yeah, Yet another cut. Sorry about that. Some interruption. There's no more cuts coming up. One of the side effects of the cuts in the interruptions is I kind of lose track of what I have done and haven't done, so I'm checking inventory and checking the people real quick here. Toyed with the idea of a high-risk run where I don't get the homeward bones and make it back to Majula by defeating the Lost Sinner. Haven't gone there. Haven't tried that yet. I will have you know that 20% of the time I make that jump 100% of the time. This startout path is still technically a pretty high risk run, so I try to invest everything into it and keep the health as high as possible. See, it's Dark Souls, you just never know what's gonna happen. It is at this point that he realized he was supposed to defeat these knights so that Masterless Glencore could... I can't keep doing the voice. I've had difficulty recently with Masterless Glencore getting defeated by these knights and not making it to the dragon. So my plan was to defeat these knights beforehand. I just realized that was my plan a bit late. And now everything's in a weird position, and I'm not sure what to do about it. So I know you've probably seen the Dragon Rider cheese a million times, but I am for some reason very bad at it. So this is kind of where the run starts, if I make it, and of course I make it this time. I make it every time. Now I have to decide what to do with these guys, and I just try to kite them in as best as I can. I usually try to get them to fall down here, but the things don't quite go the way that they should. Thank you. These Heed Knights are actually super easy to get rid of at this corner. They have almost no regard for where they stand. I'm not gonna lie here, I'm actually just pretty flustered because this isn't going the way that it should be going, and I'm not performing as well as I should be, so I'm trying to keep it low-key, trying to regain my focus here. That is the second time I've seen him do that weird half-hit in this run. I've never seen him do that before, so this is actually rather strange. Still trying to kite out these old guards, or the old knights, rather. The Heed Knights are what I'm trying to avoid, because I'd like to save those to double team them with Master Glencore with a lucky coin on, just to see if I can get any drops. And you will soon see that this will actually pay off. Pretty good RNG on this fight. This can get kind of hairy if they double team Glencore and you can't grab aggro, so this worked pretty well. I'm still just trying to keep Glencore alive. I would rather have him with me for Ornstein. I'm a little worried about Glencore at this point because he's low, and I'm kind of hoping he'll run an Estus, but he can't seem to take the hint. Okay. I tried to pull Glencore back here, but he just runs right at him. Bad position on that on the staircase, and he takes a big chunk out of his health before he actually comes back to me. This Spear Knight can be a huge problem. He can kill a lot of runs, or at least kill Glencore, but this went extremely perfect. Heed Knight Spear there, that is a that is happy dance worthy. Fantastic. I just have to get to a point where I finish the run enough to get my stats high enough to actually use it. Somehow Glencore still will not take the hint, and he will not drink the Sunny D. I toy with the idea of putting up a little more armor, but no, we're not going to do it that way. If we do this, we're going to do it pretty. We're going to be looking good the whole time. And for some reason, I always check if I can Gold Pine Resin the mace out of the Morning Star. You never can, but I still check. I really should have cut harder to the right to make the dragon turn with this fire, but it all worked out. These stomps actually don't do a lot of damage, and I would rather leave those out than run into the fire attack, because that often knocks Glencore off the platform. Take the most dragon feet. Probably the best RNG I've ever had on this fight. I mean, it was worth a shot. It's not a great sword that's really low durability, but maybe I could make some use of it, but maybe later. I gotta check that Gold Pine Resin with the Morning Star just one more time. Glencore with the stagger. Look at that. and Glencore saves himself from the third Dark Smash. Look at that, you see me not get greedy? Did you notice?
Please stop this. Ugh. I've no choice now.
I've actually had her give me problems in the past, but this is a pretty reliable strat and saves a little bit of time in the future. Here's where you just play the game of Operation. Just don't touch the sides. I don't normally kite them this hard, but this is... it's just being weird right now, so I'm a little off. I normally take, like, no damage from these guys, so I am kind of weirded out and trying to just reset. This is not fashion. Still, none of this is going the way it usually goes. I've done this section of the run a lot. I usually have it down pretty good. This is all just off. Keep Torch Bro locked up, but we'll see what he does. Rip Torch Bro. I wasn't sure what I was gonna do with him, but I decided it was probably a good idea to just get rid of him. He can get in the way, and in unexpected ways.
What? I don't think. No. From that place. But what? What? I can. You are or not? I can see. I can.
Yes, this is cinema.
Don't hesitate to call upon me.
I suddenly feel like I've never seen this building before, and it takes me a little bit to remember that this is the room I don't go into because there's nothing there. It's like they were trying to do something there and decided against it. I kind of forgot I was about to get Bradley here, otherwise I would have just had him heal me. This section is always kind of a race against time with Bradley, because he expires, so you kind of have to get as much use out of him as you can. Look at this absolute Chad Bradley. Chadley. I try to keep him away from that Vargarian, but I'm usually pretty unsuccessful. There's always a risk of him falling off when he engages that guy. GG, Bradley. Normally you can hit this bell with one of the steel arrows you get, or iron arrows, but I don't have a bow at this point for this type of run.
Gavlan, what? With Gavlan? You go home.
Just more weird positioning. I'm not sure what's up with this run. If you are careful, you can actually do this section with minimal aggro. I'm not sure exactly what triggers it, but if you get those dogs aggroed, you're done. The run is over. So, just be careful. Yes. Yes, the brigand gauntlets. The brigand armor, yes. Yes. This is fashion. Very nice, very nice.
What? Many deal. Gavlan. What? With Gavlan? View.
Let's go. This is actually my favorite armor in the game. This is definitely fashion. Look at this. Strike a pose, darling. I learned that little trick after many failed attempts and many times falling off the edge with him. I'm gonna get Lucatiel to help me out with those guys. For some reason, Lucatiel is getting stuck down here. Tricky, tricky. You gotta hit this door to aggro. And Lucatiel is back at the bottom of the stairs again. Being extra careful around the poison jars here. Thank you. thinking I'm going to do a poison dagger run here. Actually have enough time to get the poison off, but Lucatiel's lagging behind and I would rather have her and no poison, but whatever. Any minute now, Lucatiel. Too easy. I actually forget about the potential for Forlorn here, so I'm glad that didn't happen. Again, all this engagement is just weird and off. going on here. It's probably me just being rusty. It is definitely me being rusty, because I just realized what I should have done was throw firebombs at the exploding walls, and instead of getting ganked by dogs. That was way too close. That was a normal cut for ending my recording time at 1 hour. I'm just playing it safe here. These gravekeepers have really weird hitboxes and huge sweeping attacks around exploding barrels, and we're on a ledge here where we can fall off.
That might be
maximum the... cinema.
This is there. Light and
look at the beauty, the framing.
And this. I suppose
magnifique. Now that we have the antiquated key, we can get the pursuer to spawn early. And we're totally going to do that. So, technically, I don't think Dark should do extra damage to the Pursuer, but it does. So, I don't know, lol. The massive flex of parrying someone just to pop a life gem and stand there as your health slowly regains. The Pursuer is such a difficult enemy when you get started, and it's almost a shame to trivialize him like this. He's just like free twinkling Titanite at this point, because once you get the parry timing down, it's not even a fight. You do get to fight two of them later though in Dragonlight Castle. That is definitely a fun fight. And that is GG. We will pick this up on the next version, and I will totally not choke.